Hi there, everybody. This is James Lawrence, and this is my wife, Jan. And I haven't had her on a video. It's been a while. I think we did a couple of podcasts together for you. Facebook a while back ago, but it's been a good while. So now we're just doing a video that we're recording that we will place on my YouTube channel. What it's going to be about is what I've already been talking about. And in fact, in my very last video, I talked about this, and it's concerning people who go a little bit too far in saying that devils, demon spirits that are of Satan, of course, are going to harass Christians, even though they're born again in Jesus Christ and they're filled with the Holy Spirit. They have the Holy Spirit, if you prefer just to say it that way, baptized into the body of Christ by the Holy Spirit. So we have his blood, we have his name, and all these things. Yeah. And so there's no reason why we should believe that these things would attack us unless, as I said in that last video, and one I did before that was really being replaced by the one I did yesterday, in which I said in that one and this one I did yesterday that it can occur if a person is dabbling with evil things, idols, which are things that are demonic, things that make you worship something apart from God. God is the only God, and there is none other, he says. Yes. God himself said that. And he said, I'm a jealous God. And so he said, have no other gods, period, really. He said, have no other gods before me, but as he continues to describe that, he says to not bow to anything on in heaven or in earth, so therefore except for God himself. Praise God. So that, and also having serious sin or some, you know, well, let's see, I started to say, or some thing such as unforgiveness toward people, I believe can draw spirits like that to Christian people. But other than that, folks, we have the victory. Jesus gave us the victory. Mm-hmm. 2 Corinthians 6:14-16 says, be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers, for what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness, and what communion hath light with darkness, and what concord hath Christ with Belial, or the devil, or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel, and what agreement hath the temple of God with idols, for ye are the temple of the living God. As God hath said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. So, as I said, if you do yoke together with evil, as this is talking about, it's warning not to do that. You can easily have problems with demonic, satanic spirits. Now, the next one's going to be about persecution. This is different. When you're being persecuted for your Christianity, it's really Satan working through people. These spirits can't just show up and do things. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Because they won't want to. You're filled with the Holy Spirit, and you have the blood of Jesus in your life, and Jesus Christ himself is your Savior. So it says this, yea, in 2 Timothy 3:12, yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Short scripture, but if you're living godly, meaning that you love God dearly, as Jesus said, these two commandments are the main thing that you must do, and it fulfills all others. Love God with all your heart, spirit, mind, and soul, everything within you, and then to love your neighbor as yourself. And then we should also have that desire within us. We're created in Christ Jesus, not of our own works. God saves us freely by grace. But once we're saved, within us by the Holy Spirit is the desire to do good works for the Lord, and that would be to witness for Jesus Christ. And so when you love God, you love your neighbor, the fruits of the Spirit are shining in your life, you know, such as gentleness and kindness, you know, love toward others and so forth, then you're going to be persecuted. Okay, the Bible says that very clearly. Two different types of scenarios, as I think you can see. Now, what I want my wife to talk about here in just a moment is the fact that she spoke to a man at the place where she works. And he's in his mid-20s. Now, he doesn't work at the same place she does, but he was there as a customer. And he told her that he loves Lucifer, and he also called him Satan at times. My wife witnessed to him, and he said he loves Jesus too. Okay. A young lady who's an employee, where my wife is a manager, stopped by to join the conversation in a sense, and she said she thought Satan was cool too. And my wife can correct me if I didn't say that quite right. I know the girl's mother said something to that effect too. You know, it's very strange. It seems to run in families too. But anyway, the young man said that he dreamed about his parents being in some type of portal, like some spiritual portal of some type that he dreamed about. He said it was very real, and that he went into this portal. He entered it so that he could cast demons out of his parents. He said Lucifer confirmed he did the right thing because he saw an insignia, you know, a thing on a design on the back of a pickup truck that showed two upside down crosses. Now, folks, let me just mention this. My wife maybe was planning to, but I'll go ahead and just say this real quick. I've been teaching on this and trying to get a message across, but I've been having some failure at it. I've had struggles. And but at the same time, the same day I redid that message, this thing happens to my wife. This is very rare. Now, she's been in contact, she's been in conversation with people about Christianity and so forth before, but she's never gone this deep into someone's life in which they talk about satanic things like that. So what I'm going to do is just let her go ahead and talk about the things that this man spoke of, and just listen to this carefully. These are the things affecting especially the younger people in society today, people who can belong to Jesus and be born again. So if you will, my dear, my lovely wife.
I tell you what, I was so saddened by this conversation that it really put a perspective of I'm speechless, actually, but it just put a different perspective on my spiritual walk with God, and I will try to tell this the best I can. There's some things I don't remember that I said or that he said, but the first thing that I said to him, the other gentleman checked him out, and I was just standing at my register, but the gentleman turned around, and I said, "Hey, so-and-so," I won't say his name, but "do you remember God loves you?" And he said, "Oh, yes, I remember that." He said, "I had to tell you something that happened to me." He said, "I had a dream, and he said, I went through this portal." And so he brought his groceries on over to my side, and I'm like, "Okay, all right." And I was anxious to hear the story, but it led into something very disturbing. And anyway, he said that he visited with Lucifer, and my senses were just really like, do I want to hear this? And I did not want to hear it, but yet I did. But anyway, he said that he visited with Lucifer, and that he went through a portal. Mark, kind of, or James, I call him Mark, but anyway, it's James Mark. he went through a portal because he needed to get some demons out of his mom and dad's home. And so he said Lucifer helped him get the demons out of his mom and dad's home. And he said that, well, I was just telling him, I said, hey, that's dangerous ground there, you know, just letting him know that. He's like, oh no, I love Lucifer, and I'm just standing there so, you know, calm. And inside, I was shaking inside, knowing what depth of a relationship he had with Satan himself. So, I just kept saying to him, don't mess with Satan. He comes as an angel of light to deceive you. And that's in 2 Corinthians. You will find that if you look it up. And I told him just to stay away from it. And anyway, I said, Satan is deceiving you. He's trying to bring you to hell with him. And he's like, no, man. I love Lucifer. He helps me. And I tell you what, there was so much more said. I don't even know what else it was.
Didn't he say he loved Jesus too?
Yes, and he did say he loved Jesus too. And I'm like, oh boy. I was thinking, you can't do both. You can't serve Satan and Jesus at the same time. But I said one last thing. I said, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And I at least got that in. I was so thankful that I did. But, you know, it's his life. But it just really saddened me and disturbed me at the same time. But it just, when I came home and he had done that video again, I'm like, oh my goodness, I have to tell you this. And I see where the young people are really getting drawn in by Satan's deceptions. And so that's a little bit of the story, but I'll let James have the rest of it.
Well, a couple of nights ago is when we watched a man's message that was about evil spirits, you know, demonic spirits, satanic spirits, attacking Christian people. And he said it was happening because we're in the end times and Satan's wanting to scare Christians away from witnessing for him. You know, I've never heard of that, you know, that they send harassing spirits so that you won't witness because, oh, well, I'm afraid these will do something. They can't do anything because Jesus is Lord in your life.
Yes.
They aren't. And so right. You can pray and you can speak out that Jesus is my Lord. Use the sword of the Spirit, the Word of God.
Yes.
And
plead the blood of Jesus.
Yes. And what's going to have power over that? Nothing. That's the greatest power in the world. Yes. Okay? So anyway, I just wanted to put this last little bit to this to be kind of a last part of this teaching because I felt like with my not doing too well on that first video and then redoing the one I did just today, I'm going to load this one also today, but it's going to be short. Won't take it long to do. So I can do that, but you may wonder why'd you do two in a day? Because today is the day that this happened with my wife. Mm-hmm. It's a confirmation. What are the odds this would happen when I'm trying to present a message on this very subject and having a hard time doing it? But weren't you kind of disturbed by what that man was saying?
Yes, and he was showing me that a picture I left out, but he showed me the picture on his phone that he had snapshot at a drive-through window somewhere, I don't know. And he said it was a confirmation from Lucifer that he had done the right thing and that dream was real, and he was really excited about it. And it was a pickup truck with two crosses upside down.
She's talking about the young man.
Yes.
Okay.
It was two crosses upside down, and it said something on the back of the truck. It was like gibberish stuff. And the girl standing next to me, she's like, oh, yeah, that is cool. And I'm like, I can't believe my coworker, you know, does that. Is into that kind of stuff.
I was also talking about the man that did that message about how people were attacked by the shadow people.
Yes.
And stuff like that. Wasn't that pretty disturbing?
Yes, that was disturbing.
Yes.
It was.
It was disturbing to me, too. And I just almost immediately recognized, now don't forget your thought, but I immediately recognized that there was something that didn't feel right about that message. And I'm not accusing the man of being false or satanic or anything like that, and that maybe he's a messenger of Satan in disguise or something like that. No, I believe he's probably a legitimate minister. It's just that he got a little bit too much into the demonology side of the thing without talking about the power we have in God. I mean, saying more about that. So
I think he was trying to give people a heads up about, you know, be careful and stay prayerful.
Right.
You know, keep God's word in your heart, and just don't let those, you know, let your fruit show. Like James was saying,
absolutely.
Just stay in tune with the Lord each and every day, not every other day, or, you know, 7 days without prayer makes 1 week, so to speak. But anyway,
that's about it, folks. But I just wanted to bring my wife in to mention about this young man that she visited with just today. And the fact that we've been kind of disturbed over some things that were applied toward Christian people experiencing them, when you can plainly see that someone who's highly deceived, that's the guy she spoke of, and who's highly into Lucifer and things, those are the people that are going to happen. You know, he talked about the demons he had to cast away from his parents' home and stuff. I tell you, folks, let's get this thing straight, okay? And let's know that it's the evil people that are practicing these things, these weird satanic arts and witchcraft and so forth. They're drawing things like that, or having bad hatred in their life. That's a sin stronghold. And I think it can bring the presence of things like that in your life. I do. So anyway, thank you, folks, for listening. We're going to say goodnight now. God bless you, and Jim.
Bless you. Good night. Thank you.
See you later on. Bye-bye.